Ontario government was supposed to do its full budget yesterday, and it turned into a fiscal update, and it was an unveiling of a $17 billion plan that it says is going to protect businesses, protect households, public services from the worst of the economic fallout of coronavirus. So let's get some political reaction to this. Andrea Horwath joins me, the leader of Ontario's New Democrats. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. And yourself?
I'm good. You're hanging in there? You're well?
I am so far, touch wood, and doing my best, like most Ontarians, to be responsible and, you know, be physically distant from others and wash my hands and try not to touch my face.
Extraordinary times.
It really is.
Andrea, what did you think of the package unveiled yesterday by the government?
Well, the government's financial statement leaves out help for people, direct help for people, and we had been urging them for some time now to put some money in people's pockets and put some liquidity into small and medium-sized businesses right away, and unfortunately, we didn't see that yesterday. I don't think the government is hitting the mark. I mean, as I said, people are stepping up, and they needed their government to step up yesterday to help them, and that didn't happen.
Okay. So what would you have liked to have seen?
Well, we wanted to see a direct influx of support to households and to small and medium-sized businesses. What we were hoping is that the government, instead of having everybody get laid off, would be, you know, helping with payroll assistance. I know the federal government put in 10%, but we really needed to have a heck of a lot more than that. And that way people could have, even if they stayed home, would have continued to get paid, would have been continued to have some income. But, you know, that didn't happen. We also asked for a $2,000 immediate influx into households that had already been, you know, laid off and were worried about paying the bills. I mean, that's the problem. Right. I mean, folks have been up.
But the federal government has already done that, though.
No, except nothing's coming until like sometime in late April, likely. So people are up at night wondering what they're going to do. Small businesses are already shuttering their doors. They're worried about not being able to stay afloat. And that statement yesterday didn't give anybody the peace of mind to be able to get a good night's sleep. I mean, things are still, you know, very, very troubling at the ground level.
I appreciate this. You know, you come to work in the morning and there's no traffic on the road, and you know, businesses are closed all over the place, and you know, you wonder how many of these are going to open up again. Depending on the severity of this situation, but what makes you think that the Ontario government could do it any quicker than the federal government? Like direct infusions of cash into people's bank accounts.
Sure. Well, I just need to look at what other provinces have been able to do. I mean, Alberta has done that. People are already getting money from the Alberta government, and the same in Quebec. If those governments can do it, there's just no doubt that we could have done it as well. But that wasn't the focus of this government, and unfortunately, the pain is going to be deep. And that deep pain is going to be harder to get over as time rolls on. I mean, what we wanted to see is a government that was going to, you know, buoy those businesses, like tax deferrals and deferrals employer health tax and things like that. That's fine. First of all, it's a deferral, that's fine.
No.
But
yeah.
That doesn't help if your company doesn't have any revenue. It doesn't help if your doors are literally closed and there's no revenue coming in. How do you weather that storm? And so, you know, again, it was not a budget or a financial statement that is actually going to help everyday people and small and medium-sized businesses in weathering the storm.
Wow. So much for the kumbaya of recent politics, Andrea.
Well, you know, it's interesting. I mean, that's the government's kind of spin on what's been happening. But look, we were asked on Friday, late Friday, to have something to the government by end of day Sunday, which we did. I mean, we've been working on this for a long time, trying to identify the gaps, urge the government in a particular direction. And we heard nothing from the government. They didn't reach out. They didn't ask us to help craft something. They didn't give us an advance look at what they were thinking. thinking about. The first time we saw it was yesterday at 1 o'clock in our lockup. And then by 3 o'clock, or rather by 4 o'clock, 3 hours later, we were in the legislature being asked to pass it, which of course we did, because we're not going to be irresponsible. But we did flag in our debate and in our remarks these kinds of concerns that we have, that the government really needs to regroup and have a rethink on what they're doing here.
Yeah.
Because people are going to be suffering and they're not getting help from their provincial government.
Well, don't you think, though, this is going to be an evolving situation? Even, you know, at the federal level, for example, Mr. Trudeau and Mr. Morneau both said, look, we have this suite of measures right now, but if more is needed, more will be done. Don't you think this is probably just the beginning here in Ontario as well?
Well, you know, I would certainly, I would welcome the government having a rethink. That's why I asked them to do exactly that.
Okay.
Wouldn't you really put your focus on, shouldn't you put your focus on the immediate? What's happening to real families? What's happening to real businesses right now? How do we shore that up? And then look at what the longer term pieces are. I mean, it's kind of like the government of Ontario has been backwards in its response. Look, even the healthcare funding, and again, we welcome that funding. But many experts are saying it's just not enough. And of course, the government was caught flat-footed in the first place in terms of personal protective equipment and being able to supply our frontline, you know, healthcare workers who are, you know, the most at risk here and who are putting themselves at risk to make sure that the rest of us are going to be okay.
Yeah, so, they're not alone. It's the Ontario government's not alone. The federal government shipped 16 tons of that stuff off to China.
Yeah, I know.
Last month.
And this is a lesson from SARS that was supposed to be learned and wasn't.
Okay, on the healthcare front, because look, that's the single biggest expense for a provincial government in the good times.
Mm-hmm.
These are not the good times.
Mm-hmm.
What did you think about the measures announced yesterday specifically to do with healthcare?
Well, what we're hearing is the investment for PPE is not going to be enough.
Okay.
That the government's kind of approach is one that's not kind of all in. So we'll see. I mean, as you said, it's evolving. If we see what we're seeing now, which is these heartbreaking situations where everyone from, you know, PSWs going into nursing homes not having PPE to folks in hospitals ringing the alarm bells that they don't feel protected. All of that needs to be addressed. And I would hope that if the government realizes that they've shortchanged in that area, that they'll just throw more cash at it, because that's what needs to happen. People need to be safe, especially our healthcare workers on the front lines.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah.
Of course, here in Ottawa, there was some political drama and an all-nighter in Parliament because the federal Liberals, even though it's a minority parliament, felt that they would give themselves the powers of a majority for all of this year, next year. How satisfied are you of, say, legislative oversight at Queen's Park, that you have input, the ability to review decisions, question a committee, these sorts of things?
Well, we're not doing any of that. We're passing legislation in one day, in a couple of hours.
Right. The
legislation that we passed last week was very small in scope. I mean, it was to give people the opportunity to not have to bring doctor's notes for being for calling in sick, and having their jobs protected if they were following the instructions of public health or a health professional or, you know, a long list. And then the other piece was giving municipalities an opportunity to have virtual meetings and those
virtual
kinds of
council meetings.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So fairly scoped. Right. And so we did pass that in very short order, but they gave us the chance to look at the bill. We couldn't take the bill away, but we did have some minor input there. But then yesterday we had this, you know, kind of far reaching bill, and we didn't get any chance to have a look at it in advance or to actually have some input or some discussion. Literally, we had 3 hours of lockup, and then we were in the legislature. And again, we certainly didn't want to prevent the government from pushing forward.
Okay.
But we have real concerns, because this is a budget bill, and you know what budget bills are like. Likely, they're huge, right? This one wasn't as huge as a normal budget bill, because it's not really a budget; it's a financial update. But still, it was substantial, and we not only didn't have the ability to have a proper scrutiny, but neither did we have the ability to have proper debate. Didn't go into committee. Literally, introduction, second reading, a little bit of debate, and then third reading, and we were out of there.
Okay.
It took less than an hour. So for an opposition party, it's troubling. Of course, these are very unique circumstances, different circumstances, and we have to be cognizant of that. But we also need the government to to play fair in this situation. So we are going to go back probably around the 14th of April, because the government does have a requirement every 28 days to renew their kind of their emergency situation.
So we're
not just out for the foreseeable future. We're back every 28 days or so from the legislation that we first passed.
Gotcha. We got to run, but look, be well.
Yes, you
Thank
too.
You. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Andrea Horwath, the leader of Ontario's New Democrats. The news coming up, your calls, welcome. Phone lines open now, 750-1310.